Hello, you want to learn how to implement a microservice with Spring Boot, Spring Data and MongoDB? If yes, then stay tuned. In this tutorial, I will show you how to implement a complete REST service. This tutorial is split into several sections. Each section covers one area of the REST service. Let's move on the software we will use on this tutorial. We need an installed MongoDB for this tutorial. I would ask you to look on the internet how to install MongoDB for your operating system. Alternatively, you can install Docker and run MongoDB as a Docker container. We will look at the data in the MongoDB with the software Robo3T. The next software we need is Postman. With Postman, we can send HTTP requests to our REST service. Postman is free and can be downloaded from the Postman page. Alternatively, you can use another HTTP client. Then we need an IDE. I always use IntelliJ in my tutorials, but you can also use something else. Let's start with the development. First, we create a new Spring Boot project. For this, we use the website start.spring.io. We define that it is a Maven project. Then we choose Java as the programming language. We choose Spring Boot version 2.3.7. For artifact, we use customer service. We leave the other values as they are. Next, we add 4 dependencies to our project. Once the Spring Web Framework, the Spring Data MongoDB Framework, the Validation Framework, and the Lombok Framework. Now we create our project by clicking on Generate. Next, we import our project into IntelliJ. To do this, we unpack our project, then go to IntelliJ and open the project in IntelliJ. After the project is open and IntelliJ has finished loading the libraries, we can start programming. First, we create a REST controller by opening our source directory and right-clicking on New Java class. We give the class the name Customer Controller. We annotate the class with the annotation @RESTController. This defines the class as a REST controller that can accept REST requests. Then we define the URL under which the REST controller can be reached. We do this with the annotation @requestMapping. Enter /customers as the value here. This means that our customer controller can be reached under the URL localhost8080/customers. The first method we implement is the post method. With the post method, we can create new objects in the system. For this, we write a new method in our customer controller. Public customer create customer @requestBody customer customer. Annotate the method with @postMapping. With postMapping, we define that this method reacts to post requests. We see that the customer class does not yet exist. Next, we create the customer class by clicking on the customer and pressing the key combination Control Enter. Now we select Create Class Customer and create the class in the package where we are. The customer class is now created. We now define our properties First, we write a private string ID and then a private string first name. Since we have included the Lombok library, we don't have to write setters and getters now. We create the setters and getters by adding the annotation addData to the class. Since we want to store the custom objects in our MongoDB, we now need to add another annotation. We add the annotation addID to our property ID. This completes our customer class. In order to store our custom objects in MongoDB, we need a repository class. For this, we create an interface and give it the name customer repository. Now we write extends Mongo repository customer string. The first generic parameter specifies the type of the object that are loaded and stored. The second parameter specifies the type of the ID of the object. With this, we are also done with our repository. Spring Data now takes care all of the logic for us in terms of saving and loading the custom objects. Next, we implement the service class. We could have implemented all the logic in the controller, but that is not a clean software architecture in my opinion. We create a new class called Customer Service, annotate the class with @Service. Now we write private final customer repository. Since I always use the Spring Boot constructor injection, we need a constructor here. In this case, we create it with the annotation @AllArgsConstructor on the class level. Now we write a new method, public customer, create customer, 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 return customer repository, .save customer. Our service class would now also be ready. Finally, we only need to call the service class in the controller. For this, we write private final customer service, since the property customer service is final, we also have to inject it via the constructor. We do this again by writing the annotation @AllArgsConstructor to the class. We do not have to explicitly write a constructor now. Lombok does that for us. Next, we're implementing the saving of the custom object by writing the following line. Customer, customer, customer service dot create customer, customer. The custom object we get from our service method, we pass on to a response entity object and return that as the result of the controller. Here we make sure that HTTP status.created is returned. We defined a wrong return value when recreating the controller. We now change this and write response entity customer instead of customer. Our controller with the first method is now ready. We start our Spring Boot application and see if it starts successfully. Yes, it does. Now we can test our application. For this, we switch to Postman. We will now test our new REST method with Postman. For this, we enter the URL http localhost 8080/customers here. Since it is the POST method, we change this to POST. Next, we go to the body area. Here we select raw, then we select JSON. Now we can fill our request body. Our custom object has two properties, once ID and first name. We will not enter the ID here because it is assigned by MongoDB. That means we only enter first name with the value Michael. Then we click on send. We see that we get an HTTP 201 back. This means that our object was created in our system. Now let's take a quick look at our response body. As we can see, we have our custom object with an ID here. Now we look at the whole thing again in the database. For this, we open Robot3T, connect to our MongoDB, open our database and our collection. We see that we have a document in our collection. The object ID is the same as the one we saw in Postman. This ensures that our service is writing to the database. We are now done with the first part of the tutorial. In this part, we learned how to create a Spring Boot project, how to create a REST controller, how to create a repository interface, how to implement a model class, how to layer the software architecture, how to implement the POST method, and how to test the POST method with Postman. In the second part of my tutorial, I will show you how to implement GET methods to fetch data from the REST service. If you like my tutorial, I would be very happy about a like. Subscribe to my channel for more interesting tutorials. I say goodbye and wish you good luck with the development.